करने के नहीं अपने को इतना करने का।
चलो आप बता दो स्टार्ट, मैं जा रहा हूँ।
हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो टुडे वी सी द कंटिन्यूएशन। फर्स्ट लेट अस सी द रिवीजन ऑफ द प्रीवियस क्लास। Revision of previous topic. So what all we have discussed in the previous topic that we should see? First we have seen the introduction of solutions, So then we have seen types of solutions means how many based on the physical state. We have seen nine types of solutions. Then we have studied concentration methods. We have finished this one. There are seven concentration methods: mass by mass method, mass by volume, ppm, molarity, molality, mole fraction, normality, and all. We have said about all these things. Then next, we have studied solid in liquid. Yes. So this we have finished, and there we have studied about the factors affecting solubility. That is also over. Next we have studied about solubility of gas in liquids. There we have seen the factors affecting solubility. In factors, point number one, temperature, we have seen, which is inversely proportional to solubility. And point number two, it is pressure, which is directly proportional to solubility. Right? Hope you all remember these things, because these all things are studied in the previous topic. Then we have studied Henry's law. Here only we have studied Henry's law and Henry's law formula. What was the Henry's law formula? P gas is equal to KH into X gas. So this we have studied. Then applications of Henry's law. Henry's law applications also we have seen three applications. So what are those three applications? Soda bottles. Soda bottles are sealed under high pressure. One, to increase the solubility of CO2 in water. And oxygen cylinders carried by scuba diver contain small amount of helium to avoid bends. And people living at high altitude suffer from anoxia. So these all things we have studied in the previous topic. So this is the revision of the previous one. Now continuation. So today we are going to see the very interesting topic and important topic. This is Raoult's law. So Raoult's law, if you want to learn Raoult's law, we should recall the basic terms: vapor pressure and partial pressure. These two terms are very useful and needed in numericals. Without knowing these two words, you cannot enter into the next one. Yes, the topic is vapor pressure and partial pressure. Yes, vapor pressure symbol is P naught. And the second one is partial pressure symbol is P suffix A or P suffix B. See, these two words are very important. If you understand these two, the remaining whole topic will look easy. Otherwise it's a difficult term. Vapor pressure means what? Here in a container we take any one liquid. Remember that. liquid is taken. So liquid like anything, water, alcohol, anything. Now we close the container. So container is closed and the liquid slowly vaporizes. Liquid slowly vaporizes and the vapor is developed. And this vapor will exert some pressure. Vapor exerts some pressure on the surface of liquid, which is called as vapor pressure. Clear? So it means it is the pressure exerted by the vapor of a liquid. By the vapor of a liquid. And on the surface of liquid, that is called as vapor pressure. It depends on two factors. Factors affecting vapor pressure. Point number one, temperature. Yes, tell me how the temperature is related with vapor pressure. What do you think? So when temperature is increased, vapor pressure is increased or decreased? So as temperature increases, the amount of vapor increases, so automatically vapor pressure also increases. So temperature is directly proportional to vapor pressure. Second factor, it is strength of intermolecular force. Yes, strength of intermolecular force. How it is related? If the intermolecular force is weak, then evaporation will be more, and that means vapor pressure is more. So which means strength of intermolecular force is inversely proportional to vapor pressure. This is vapor pressure concept. Now partial pressure, the important thing is here we take mixture of liquids. You see, here only one liquid is taken and here mixture of liquids. Let us say the A liquid and some B liquid. This is B liquid. So now when the container is closed, A molecules also vaporizes as well as B molecules also vaporize. So here there is a vapor of A molecule and B molecule. So mixture of liquid A and B. So both the molecules are vaporizing. Now the pressure exerted by the vapor of any liquid over the mixture of liquids, over the mixture of liquids, that is called as vapor pressure, partial pressure. You see, it's the pressure exerted by the vapor of liquid on surface, but here pressure exerted by the vapor of any one liquid, vapor of any one liquid over the mixture of liquids. Over the mixture of liquids, and that is called as partial pressure. So it means when we have two or more components, we use the word partial pressure, and when we have only one component, then we use the word vapor pressure. This is, we have studied in 11th also, in states of matter chapter, we studied about partial pressure and vapor pressure. You can revise those notes also, it will be very clear. So make the notes of it. Then we will start the very interesting topic, no doubt. So you must have taken the note of it. Now after vapor pressure, then we are starting the topic of Raoul's law. Topic now, it is Raoul's law. So very important 3 marks numerical based on this. Raoul's law is about the solubility of solid in liquid, liquid in liquid and gas in liquid. So that means Raoul's law first case, solubility of solubility of solid, but we don't use the word solid here, we use the word non-volatile solute. So this is very important word. So in numericals they use this word only, non-volatile solute, means which does not evaporate or vaporizes, that is called non-solid. In liquid solvent, so the case one is solubility of non-volatile solute in liquid solvent. Yes, what we can see here, so take a liquid, any liquid, example water. This is a container and water is taken here. So here the pressure is there, what can you call that pressure, partial pressure or vapor pressure? We have only water and the pressure is called as vapor pressure. So let the vapor pressure, the vapor pressure of water is P naught. Water you can say, or solvent, vapor pressure of solvent also. Let the vapor pressure of solvent is P naught. Now in this we add solute, but which solute? Non-volatile solute. What do you mean by non-volatile solute? Which is nothing but simply solid. We are adding the solid. So after adding the solid, what happens to the pressure? The pressure is called as total pressure. Like the pressure of solution after adding that solid is, let us say, the P. Now what happens to the pressure value that we should see here? This is closed container. This is the first diagram, and second diagram, so this is pure water. And this is water plus glucose. In pure water, the surface is covered with water molecules only. There are only water molecules which can evaporate, and here you can find large number of water molecules in the vapor phase. This is surface. So here this is a vapor. Vapor of water molecules. But when I add non-volatile solute, some solute molecules will present here. The red molecules are solute. Some solute molecules are present and some water molecules are present. Now these red molecules are non-volatile, so they cannot evaporate and they reduce the evaporation of water. So here the quantity of vapor is decreased. You see, the previously the quantity of vapor was more, now the quantity of vapor is reduced. It means on adding non-volatile solute, solute to solvent, the pressure of solution is decreased. The pressure of solution is decreased due to reduce in the vaporization of solvent. Yes, this is the main point here. See here, this figure is very important. If you understand the figure, then it is easy. See, this is the point number one. We have taken pure water. The surface is covered with only water molecules. So water is a volatile one, so which can evaporate, so more vapor is created. But when non-volatile solute is added, solid, the red molecules are solid molecules. So these solid molecules do not volatile or do not vaporize. That's why the vapor quantity is decreased. You see, the vapor is less and here the vapor is more because of solid molecules. So it means ultimately the vapor pressure on adding non-volatile solute to the solvent, the pressure of solution is decreased due to reduce the vaporization of solvent. So which means I can say here P is less than P naught. Here the P value is less than P naught value. Is it right? Understood this? This is the most important. Then after it is easy. Now according to Raoult's law, Raoult's law says the pressure of solution is directly proportional to, here pressure value depends on which one, solute or solvent. If the solvent is more, then pressure will be more. If solvent is less, pressure will be less. So we can say the pressure of solution is directly proportional to mole fraction of which one? Solute or solvent? Solvent. Solute does not vaporize. It even does not allow the liquid to vaporize. So solute is non-volatile, so we ignore it. Solvent. So the pressure of solution is directly proportional to mole fraction of solvent. So I can write symbolically P is proportional to mole fraction of solvent, symbol X, B. Solvent is B. So now P is equal to, we remove the proportional symbol, we put constant K into XB. P is equal to K into XB. To find the value, this is the equation number one. Let here we have to find the value of K. For that, what do you do? Let XB is equal to 1. XB is 1. Then XA will be 0. Because when the sum of the mole fraction of solute and solvent should be 1. If XB is 1, then XA will be 0. At that case, the pressure of solution becomes, here solute is not there. So only solvent, the pressure is equal to vapor pressure of solvent. Am I right? Because there is no solute, there is only solvent. That means pressure of solution will equal to the vapor pressure of solvent. Both will be equal. So put this in the above condition. So in the place of P, what can we put? P naught is equal to K into 1. Implies P naught is equal to K. We have got the value of K now. So put the value of K in 1. So from 1, what can you write? From 1, P is equal to P naught into XB. This is the formula which we can use in numericals for the Raoult's law of this formula. When it is used when there is a question of non-volatile solute, so this I can extend more. So here we know that XA plus XB is equal to 1. implies xb is equal to 1 minus xa. That we can put here. So p is equal to p naught into 1 minus xa. So we can divide here, p upon p naught is equal to 1 minus xa. So now we can rearrange this. So xa is equal to 1 minus p upon p naught. So xa means number of moles of a upon number of moles of a plus number of moles of b is equal to LCM we can take. So p naught minus p upon p naught. For dilute solution, the value of Na is very less than Nb. So here Na can be ignored. So therefore final answer p naught minus p upon p naught is equal to Na over Nb. This is the formula, second formula. So you can use any of the formula in numericals, either this formula or that formula, both are same. So this is Raoult's law case. Here we should know some words. Some words means what is p naught minus p. P naught is what? P naught is vapor pressure of solvent. P is pressure of solution. Either p is less than p naught. So p naught minus p indicates what? P naught minus p indicates, previously we said the pressure is decreased, but how much it is decreased, that you will come to know with this one. So p naught minus p indicates lowering of vapor pressure, how much pressure is decreased. And this term p naught minus p upon p naught indicates what? This is called a relative lowering of vapor pressure. Relative means comparatively. Comparatively, how much pressure is decreased. This is P naught minus P. So it is all about Raoult's law for solid in liquid. So it is very simple. Don't get confused. So listen very carefully and simply mind. See, we take first solvent. Solvent pressure is P naught. We add solute, then pressure is P. But when you add solute, the pressure is decreased. So P is less than P naught. Clarity? So how much pressure is decreased? That we have to find. For that, according to Raoult's law, the pressure of solution is directly proportional to mole fraction of solvent. So P is proportional to XB. And then we got P is equal to P naught into XB. And again, simplification. Here P naught minus P tells us what, how much pressure is decreased, means lowering of vapor pressure. Then P naught minus P upon P naught tells us what, and that tells us about relative lowering of vapor pressure. So comparatively, how much pressure is decreased. So this is Raoult's law, first case. So take notes of it. So this theory point, on adding non-volatile solute, the pressure of solution is decreased. Why it is decreased? Due to reducing vaporization of solvent. When solute is added, solvent vaporizes less. That's why the pressure is decreased. Make notes. Fine. So now next category, that is the solubility of liquid in liquid. Now, case number 2 is the Raoult's law. Case number 2, that is the solubility of liquids in liquids. Solubility of liquids in liquids. So it means solute is also liquid and solvent is also liquid. Both are liquids. So here you take two figures. First, this is only solute. This is only solute and its pressure. What can you use the word vapor pressure or partial pressure? Only solute, so its vapor pressure. Its vapor pressure is P naught A. Now here you take another figure. This is only solvent. This is only solvent and its pressure, you can say, that is a vapor pressure P naught B. Correct? Now mixing both. Here we are taking another figure. So here both A and B are mixed. This is the A liquid and here B liquid is also mixed. This is mixture. Mixture of A and B. Mixture of A and B. Here there will be the pressure due to A molecule. Is A molecule and there will be pressure due to B molecules. It's a closed container. So the pressure due to A molecule is called what? Here we don't use vapor, we use partial pressure. Partial pressure of A is given by the symbol P suffix A. Similarly, partial pressure of B. Partial pressure of B is given by symbol P suffix B. So I think it's a clear figure now. Here we have only solute, its vapor pressure is P naught A only. And here we have only solvent, its vapor pressure is P naught B. Now mixing both A and B are mixed, then we use the word partial pressure, not vapor pressure. Partial pressure of A is BA. Partial pressure of B is PB now. Yes. Now, based on this, we should find the total pressure. So, on mixing A and B, according to Dalton's law, total pressure of solution, P is equal to sum of the partial, that is the PA plus PB. That is the equation number 1. So we have to find this one. What is the PA value? What is PB value? Here I use Raoult's law. According to Raoult's law, here the pressure of A, the pressure due to A depends on which one? The pressure due to A depends on the mole fraction of A. And pressure due to B depends on mole fraction of B. So according to Raoult's law, the partial pressure of A is directly proportional to mole fraction of A. And the partial pressure of B is directly proportional to mole fraction of B. Correct? So here the quantity of A, if it is more, the pressure due to A will be more. If the quantity of B is more, then pressure due to B will also be more. So pressure of A is directly proportional to mole fraction of A and the pressure of B is directly proportional to mole fraction of B. When you remove the proportionality symbol, we put some constant, that is a K1 into HA. And here PB is equal to K2 into XB. So we have to find K1 and K2. To find K1, what we do is, if xA is equal to 1, then xB will be 0. And under this condition, the partial pressure becomes what? Here only A is there, there is no B. So only A is there, then the pressure will equals to, the partial pressure will equals to vapor pressure. Here we are thinking that there are two liquid, A and B. If there is no B, only A is there, then these two will be same. These two will be same. So that means the partial pressure will equals to vapor pressure. Put that in the above case, what you will get? P naught A is equal to K1 into 1. So which means K1 is equal to P naught A. Now put that K1 here, therefore, so here from this what can you write? PA is equal to P naught A into FA. That is equation number 2. Done? Equation number 2. Now here, similarly, what we can assume here, if to find the value of K2, what we are doing is, if XB is equal to 1, then XA will be 0. At that case, the partial pressure of B will equal to, here what we are assuming, A is not there, let us assume A is not there, only B is there. Then if B is there, then partial pressure will equals to vapor pressure of B. So which means PB is equal to P naught B. Put that in the above case. So P naught B is equal to K2 into 1. So implies K2 is equal to P naught B. Put this K2 here. Therefore, final answer, PB is equal to P naught B into XB. This is equation number 3. So I think we have got now. So now we have got PA and PB values. Put this PA and PB in 1. So from equation 1. So P is equal to PA plus PB. And PA and PB values we have got. So PA means P naught A XA. Plus PB means P naught B XB. So this is the formula to calculate the pressure of liquid in liquid. Where, let us recall the meaning of each term, PE. Where PE is pressure of solution, P naught A is vapor pressure of A, P naught B vapor pressure of B. XA and XB are known to us as the mole fraction of A and B. It is about Raoult's law of liquid in liquid. So it is Raoult's law case. Here we can have graphs. Last time we forgot draw graphs. So here we can draw graphs. On y-axis we take pressure. On x-axis we take mole fraction. That is XA is equal to 0. At the max, XA will equals to 1. If XA is equal to 0, then XB will equals to 1 here and XB will equals to 0. So from 2, this one we are taking. It is looking as Y is equal to MX. It is looking as Y is equal to MX, isn't it? So graph will be straight line but passing through origin. So it means the graph will be somewhat like this. This one is the line. So, yes. And what is the end value? At the last we reached XA is equal to 1. If XA is equal to 1, the pressure will equals to P naught A. Here it is P naught A. Here you can put also XA is 1, XB is equal to 0. So P, pressure is equal to P naught A. This one over. Now we have to draw one more graph here. It is also looking as y is equal to mx. So its graph can also be drawn. But for this, the origin will be point where xb is 0. Here the origin point is where xb is 0. So this point will be origin. So the graph will be like this. Graph will come like this. So this is the graph for PB is equal to P naught B XB, and this is the graph for PA is equal to P naught A XA. PA is equal to P naught A XA. So now when you join these two, you will get the line of pressure. That is, the pressure P is equal to PA plus PB. And what is this pressure? What is this value? This is vapor pressure of solvent. That is a P0B. P0B and P0A are different. Generally, solvent is more volatile than solute. So that's where the solvent pressure will be more than the pressure of solute. That's why P0B value is more, P0A value is less. So it is all about Raoult's law of liquid and liquid. Unless you have patience, then you will confuse. So to understand these all, you should have patience. You should listen carefully, rewind the video and you can see it. See, it's very simple. A liquid, B liquid. A liquid pressure is P0A, B liquid pressure is P0B. Now mixing both A and B, then the pressure will be due to A also, pressure will be due to B also. The pressure due to A depends on mole fraction of A. The pressure due to B depends on mole fraction of B. Then we got PA is equal to P0A XA and PB is equal to P0B XB. According to Dalton's law, P total is equal to PA plus PB, and we have drawn this. And two equations, two graphs, y is equal to mx, y is equal to mx. But here origin is that place where xa is 0. This one is the origin, the graph will go in this way. And this is the graph where xb is 0. Xb is equal to 0 is the origin point. So it will go in this direction. So both when you can join, so p is equal to pa plus pb. And now extra point. Here PA, what is PA? Pressure, partial pressure of A. Partial pressure of A. And PB, partial pressure of B. But in vapor phase, how to find mole fraction? Mole fraction in vapor phase. The formula is PA is equal to P total into YA, where YA is mole fraction in vapor phase, XA is mole fraction in liquid phase. This I am erasing. So here XA and XB are mole fractions in liquid phase, and if you want the mole fraction in vapor phase, there will be numerical where they can ask, find the mole fraction in vapor phase. So PA is equal to P into YA and PB is equal to P into YB. Yes. So YA and YB are the mole fractions in vapor phase. So it's all about Raoult's law case. So revise it, rewind it and recall. So revise, rewind and recall, they are most essential ones. So listen carefully and make the notes. Fine. So solubility of liquid in liquid is over. And next, third category, it is solubility of gas in liquid. Solubility of gas in liquid.
So we can see here, we have two formulas, Raoult's law of solid in liquid. Raoult's law of solid in liquid. What are the formulas we have derived? Two formulas. One is P is equal to P naught B into XB. Other one, P naught minus P upon P naught is equal to XA, or rather we have simplified as NA over NB. So this we have derived and we have studied. Point number one. Number two, Raoult's law of liquids in liquids. We have finished just now. Yes, what we have studied, tell me the formula. P is equal to PA plus PB, partial pressure of A plus partial pressure of B, which is equal to PA ki jagah pe P naught AXA, and PB means P naught B XB. These two things we have studied, and in vapor phase, if I want to find the mole fraction in vapor phase, the PA is equal to P total into YA, and PB is equal to P total into YB. So this is the summary of the previous topic. So this till this we have studied. There is one more case remaining, the third one. It is which one? Solubility of Raoult's law of solubility of gas in liquid. So which means gas is a solute and liquid is a solvent. So liquid is solvent. So this category is remaining. So once if we finish this, then Raoult's law is over. Yes. So here, let vapor pressure of gas is P naught A or B. Gas is solute, solute means A. The pressure of solution, let the pressure of solution is P. Now according to Raoult's law, so here you see there's a figure. Here liquid is taken, it is a liquid solvent, and here we add gaseous solute. So here gas molecules are there. Let us see gas. Now when you close the container, the gas will vaporize and liquid also vaporize. But the quantity of vapor or gas will be more than the quantity of liquid, because gas will vaporize very fast. Gas will vaporize faster than liquid. That's why I can say, according to Raoult's, the pressure of solution is directly proportional to mole fraction of which one? Mole fraction of both should be there, but it is a very negligible, solvent is negligible solute. So the pressure of solution is directly proportional to mole fraction of solute. So P is equal to K into XA. So to find the value of K, if XA is equal to 1, XB is equal to 0, at this condition the pressure of solution is equal to, let us assume solvent is not there, the pressure of solution is equal to vapor pressure of gas. So put that in the above case. So P is equal to P naught, if you put that in the above case,
in the place of P we can put P naught A is equal to K into 1, implies K is equal to P naught A. So put the K value in this equation, so we will get P is equal to P naught A into XA. This is the formula. This formula is used for Raoult's law of gas and solute. So I'll tell you, some students have confusion. First case, solid in liquid. Solid in liquid. Second case, liquid in liquid. Some of you must be having confusion. But it is very easy, pretty easy thing. Gas in liquid. See, here the pressure is directly proportional to what? What is more volatile? What is more volatile, solute or solvent? Solvent. That's why T is proportional to XB. And here both are volatile, that's why TA is proportional to XA and PB is proportional to XB. Here both are volatile. Now in this case, in the third case, gas and liquid, which is more volatile? Of course both are volatile, but gas is more volatile. That's why the pressure is directly proportional to XA. Pressure is directly proportional to XA. This is a simple, simplified one. So if you have any confusion, you can ask me, you can send WhatsApp, you can just revise on all things. So this is a very easy thing. So this is the Raoult's law of three cases, solid in liquid, liquid in liquid and gas in liquid over. Now there is a question. If the students are very smart, they can ask, sir, we have also studied about Henry's law for solubility of gas and liquid. So we can compare. So comparing the Raoult's law with Henry's law. Comparing the Raoult's law with Henry's law. So what happens? So according to Raoult's law, what is the formula? P is equal to P naught A into XA. And Henry's law. What is Henry's law statement? P is equal to KH into XA. So comparing the both, if vapor pressure of gas means P naught A is equal to Henry's constant of gas. Henry's constant means KH of gas. Then I can say Raoult's law will be same as or will be the case of Henry's law or vice versa. So if the Henry's constant of the gas is equal to vapor pressure of gas, then Raoult's law will be the case of Henry's law or Henry's law will be the case of Raoult's law. So it's a finished one. Raoult's law topic is over. Raoult's law of three cases. So based on that, we can do some numericals. I'm giving you some exercise questions. So you solve these exercise questions. Hold on. You can see these questions. Question number 15, 16, 17, 18, 19,
then 21 21 yes, these questions are strictly based on Henry's law, sorry, Raoult's law. They all are based on Raoult's law. So after listening this topic, so you solve these questions, so then you will come to know to what extent you understood this topic. So solve these exercise questions 15 16 15 16 17 18 19 and 21 questions. Yes, Raoult's law topic is over. Now we will see the types of solutions. Continuation next class.